this whole time. How many manifest yourself? How many glorify yourself? Hallelujah. Amen. Did you get it? At least if you get the chorus, you can get it, isn't it? Alabadaina, the one with us. Okay. Put it there for us. I'm sure that.
So I think that we want to see this. Let's do it again. Your name is full of wonders. us with songs of the fire. We glorify your name. Alright. Over mountains high and low.
Come on, I love you.
If you don't take it, we'll be singing the low offering. Are you getting it? Those of you at the back here, if you can move forward, I will really appreciate it. So that we know that you have actually come to church. When you are at the back, sometimes like you haven't come. But you have come, isn't it? Right. So please. You don't have, you haven't been able to write the words, you see. Take out a very, very good offering. Let's give a good offering. Our time is almost now, as you can see. So every time we have to try and learn some songs so that we change our repertoire, isn't it? Please take out a good offering. I'm watching you, so we are not moving at all. Dennis, we are not moving at all. Or is moving. Take out a good offering. Everybody, these ladies, look at them. Anita, take out an offering. Hey. The way you have squeezed your hand, the money must be very small. Tell me 5 pesos. Hey! Robert, have you taken an offering? Some of you, we don't get you here, so when we get you like this, you have to bring the offering. Beautiful, beautiful. Have you taken out? Iman, are you sure? But your hand, the way it's on your chair, it doesn't look like it's holding money. Is it holding money? Are you sure? Okay, what about the people behind me? Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for tonight. We ask for your blessing over every seed that is being sown. Bless every life. Change our financial situations. In the name of Jesus, let there be financial ascendancy in our lives. In this month of May, which is the fifth month, Father, make grace appear upon us. Grant us all grace that we shall have all sufficiency in all things, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you. Come on the way to the front. And then, those who are giving by mobile, the number is 055-77-14458. 055-77-14458. 055-77-14458. Come on. Should listen to last Sunday's message. Wow. that Bishop Dad preached. Hallelujah. Yeah. You know, amazingly, I asked some people to listen to that camp. And I was surprised when I heard him say, he's doing a new series, and the series is on that which I told the people to listen to. I tell you, it's amazing. So it just shows that God is doing something, and I just felt that, listen, if the thing I've asked us to listen to and is being preached, then we should listen to it. And many of us, truly, you know, you don't listen to the unity set, you don't join. How many joined last Sunday? Look at that. Look at that. How many have listened to it? You see. So, if I don't bring it, you see that you will not listen to it. So, we are going to listen to all of us, and I believe God is going to speak to us. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you are ready as I am, if the sound people are also ready, the screen people, we want to listen to our own father and prophet. I believe that even in this season, as we get ourselves ready to celebrate the Founders Day, it will be good to be hearing his voice speak to us. Yeah, so I'm sure that we'll be doing that. We may probably be even doing a loyalty night. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But put your hands together. Let's receive our father and our prophet.
Thank you, Father, for over which the Holy Spirit has made you an overseer. And for every church, the Holy Spirit chooses and makes the overseer. And in this church, we are blessed to have our overseer and our good shepherd in the man who in any of the denominations have the spirit of the denominations. They hear so that move the mind. And then he said something to the effect of truth in purpose. All right? 1,000 micro churches.
Amen.
All right? Now, I preached on all these things in the past, but I remember we were going deeper.
Yeah.
And I remember that these things are very important. I remember reading something by Rick Joyner. He said in a vision he met with John Wesley. And John Wesley told him something. He said, John Wesley said, I was given some truths. And in the vision, he was given a horse. And what else was he given? A horse and a torch. Yes. And then he said something to the effect that I taught what was given to me in such a way as to create a movement. And that movement has continued to move on. So up to today, it's working. So that is why you hear all the camps that are held in the UD, the UO, in any of the denominations have the same titles and themes that have been given to us, including a theme like going deeper and doing more. Because if you didn't remember anything, at least you remember going deeper and doing more. I mean, at least you remember that after all the weeks that I've been preaching, you don't remember anything. There's something about deeper and something about more. What do you think? Something deeper, something more. And we are teaching what we are teaching in such a way as to create a movement which will carry on till Jesus returns.
Amen.
So 1,000 micro churches is one of such important teachings. 1,000 micro churches. Now the vision to have 1,000 churches, do you see, is a vision that I'm trying to give to you personally. Do you see? that through you we can generate 1,000 churches. I'm trying to help you to understand the word of God. Now, I don't mean one church. I mean 1,000 micro churches. A church which is less than 100 is in micro church zone. And from 100 and onwards is mega. Okay? So below 100 is micro. Okay? And going above 100 is going towards the mega. So, Many people don't respect how great and important it is for the church to exist. Do you see? But the church is such a great organism that God creates and builds. And you must be careful with the church, because nobody, amen, are you listening?
Yes.
Please pay attention. I see every single person that I'm watching only you on TV. So when you are talking and moving and all, I look on your phone. I see it from here. Even somebody far away that I can see what they are doing. So please. Now, 1,000 micro churches. Number one, why you must have 1,000 micro churches? You see, if all of us here become a church, that's 1,000 churches. Yes, everybody here becomes a micro church. It becomes a mega church. Amen. Now, in Acts chapter 4, number one, the first reason is that you must build 1,000 micro churches because it is your way to build the mega church. Amen. In Acts chapter 4, verse 4, the Bible says, howbeit, many of them which heard the word and believed, the number of the men was about 5,000. 5,000. Alright? Now, you see, God's word, 5,000 people in those days, look at the population. They had 5,000 people in the church. Now, there are very few churches with 5,000 seats. They may mention numbers. And if you try to count, you'll find out few churches have 5,000 members sitting there on a Sunday. It's a rare thing. It's far more rare than you want to imagine. It's not common. In all my travels across the world, I found that to have 5,000 souls in one place to preach to is a very, very unusual thing. And I've preached in many churches. I've preached in churches. Yes. Many famous churches too, by the grace of God, including the most famous of all, Ngicho's Church. Yes. So it's not common to build a church with 5,000 to even match up with what was in the New Testament. But one of the ways that we can attain to the Bible standards of 5,000 souls or the mega church is to have 1,000 micro churches. Yes. One, all over the place. Do you see? Now, if you look at the Redeemed Church of God, those of you who have a television, Christian television, if you watch DAF television, by the way, the songs we were singing, that's Tommy Walker, very famous, it's one of my favorite worship leaders. That's Tommy Walker's beautiful songs, okay? What are the other songs that he has? I don't know how to sing it, so sing it. Never gonna stop. Holy Spirit, come, I fix my eyes on you. All those songs, we are out on the waters. All right? Okay. Now, the way you can have a mega church is to have 1,000 micro churches. And so, 1,000 micro churches is going to involve all of us. Because there's going to be a church everywhere. Once you exist, a church will form around you. What do you think? And once you are not doing it for money, it's far easier. If you are looking for money, and you are looking for a salary, or something like that, then you come into difficulty. But if you are looking to get involved in building the church, then you will suddenly say, yes, 1,000 micro churches, me involved, yes, why not? Because the lay system, the lay ministry, is still the mainstay of this church and of every church that is large. It's lay people working. And our church has a policy of having mostly lay people. We even send laymen, like people that are not paid by the church. We even send such people on missions. We even send people who are students on missions. I can mention so many people who are students in different countries on missions. All right, and lay people to even find jobs in places. And they are on missions. Recently, we had a couple of missionaries leaving for Bangladesh just a few weeks ago. They are in Dhaka. And they are there. You know, they are working as teachers in Bangladesh. Do you see? And with a congregation. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So they are laymen. They are not collecting salary or any other payments. Are you listening to me? So, the way that we can attain to 5,000 members, which is a mega church, is for everybody who is here to be involved in building 1,000 micro churches. How many realize that we are suddenly employed by the Lord? Beautiful. That is amazing. Number two, the second reason why you must be involved in 1,000 micro churches is because it is your way of being about your Father's business.
Amen.
He said, I must be about my Father's business. Luke 2 and verse 49. I must be about my Father's business. Now, you see, you can have a father, but you are not involved in your Father's business.
That's true.
Yeah. I mean, your father could build a hospital, and you never work in the hospital or be involved in your father's hospital. You know what I'm saying? Your father could be a lawyer, but you never work in your father's chambers of lawfare. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Your father could be running a spare parts shop at wherever, Apostle Kai or Kokon Bay. But even though you grow up and mature, you never get involved in your father's business.
Yeah.
That's how life is. Life is such that you can live, grow up, and die without ever getting involved in your personal father's business.
Yeah.
My father had a hotel. He actually had the biggest and the best private hotel in Accra. At a point. In fact, he was the president of the Ghana Private Hoteliers Association at a point. Yes. So he was running a hotel. Now, One day he got sick, getting to the end of his life. And then I got involved in my father's business. Just for a short while, till he got well. When he got well, then I lost my job. Yeah. But you know, I was a doctor. And I was going into ministry. So I wasn't into hotel business. I've managed a hotel before because I did some of my father's business for a short while. Yeah. What I'm trying to say is that you can work and live and never join in your father's business. Yeah. Now when you stand in heaven one day and your father and heavenly father is looking at you and says, what business, what work did you do on earth? Do you see? And it's like, oh, spare parts. I was a spare parts dealer. Oh, I was a curtain seller. I was an iron rod dealer. I was an importer, exporter. Here's my complimentary card. I was a politician. I was a tailor. I was everything. So the father will ask you, so do you know my business, my work that I was doing on earth? He said, oh yes, I know. So you never thought it was anything good. When I see my son Joshua being involved in my business, it touches my heart. Yes, touches my heart. Yes. Because my son is involved in his father's business. He never needed to be here. He's a lawyer. Even the places he worked in the financial whatever of the UK, they call him still. Inviting him, come for the job you were doing. You have Dubai, this, that. But you always tell them, I'm doing my father's business. Yes, I'm working with my father, my father's business that he's doing. And every father would be happy that his child is doing something in his business.
Amen.
You get what I'm saying?
Amen.
Unless there's something else going on. Yeah. Are you there with my living? I must be about my father's business.
Amen.
Should it be that you will live through this life and never even touch your father's work, your father's interests on this earth? Eh?
Yeah.
You know, sometimes parents make a lot of investments. You know, sometimes your father can die, and because you never showed any interest in what he was doing, some strangers will possess his things which were to come to you. Because maybe he wanted to show you. You know, when my father died, I knew certain things, I could go straight to his business, to things that he was into. But if I had known, I would have no idea. And people's parents die and you have no idea. And strangers take over things and loot the place. Oh yeah. For a while, checkbooks have disappeared. I mean, properties, lands, houses. You go and say, oh, pardon? They say, pardon? And it vanishes. Entire houses vanish. And sometimes the reason is your father's house in Konongo, you never went there. You never saw it or saw it. But, my father has a house at Konongo. My father has a house somewhere and you have no idea what it is like. Yes. So sometimes we make great losses because we are not so interested in what our parents do. Yes. And I'm telling you this. seen even in church. So being about your father's business and showing interest is very important. And you may not have a father to tell you, but I'm telling you today that being interested in what your father does, do you see, is a great blessing. And even your relative, you know, when I look at my wife's family, there's hardly any member of a family that is not in the church somewhere. Once they recognize that this is our sister's family church, do you see, all of them became part of the church. Yeah, because you see, your sister is supposed to inherit all your things, so don't forget. Anyway, that's just a joke. But I'm saying that you don't even care about your father's business and businesses. Do you know what our heavenly father's businesses here are? All the churches in Ghana and Accra are the father's business.
That's right. Yeah.
And that is why all churches are of great importance to God. Not only your church. It's the Father's work on this earth. Are you excited about that?
Yeah.
Number three, you must build 1,000 churches because it is the way to defeat Satan at the gates of hell. In Matthew 16 and verse 18, Jesus said, I also say to thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock, alright, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against you. Now, the gates of hell are the gates of hell. And the gates of your house are the gates of your house.
Yeah.
Why do you want to play the match? In front of your gate or in front of Satan's gate? Huh? Which goalpost do you want us to be playing?
The enemy's goalpost.
In front of your house or at his house?
At his house.
Now, the gates of hell are mentioned only once in the Bible. And it's mentioned in association with building the church. Once you start building the church, you've moved the match to the enemy's gate.
Wow.
Yeah, you've moved everything to in front of his house.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I tell you, he's not comfortable at all.
Yeah.
Do you think Satan is comfortable that we are building a cathedral in Drobo or in Domahinko or in Kenyasi or in where? Hedium. And where? Yendi, Yeji, and me, and Gosu, and Tepa. My dear, I need the names. And what again? Dawa Dawa number two. That's my son, Peter of Dawa Dawa. Satan doesn't want you to build. So once you start building churches and planting 1,000 micro churches, look, I tell you, you've moved the match away from your house to the gates of hell.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
And somebody will say, but I don't want to disturb the gates of hell. You know, because I think it will cause Satan to attack me. I don't want that. Let me tell you, he's attacking you whether you want him to attack you or not. It's a matter of where they are playing the match. We are playing the match in front of Satan's mouth. The only time that I've really enjoyed Black Stars is when that player, Adia, do you know Adia? I don't know him, but I just remember that he was a golden boot. He's the one who headed the ball into the net and this Suarez caught it. As during the World Cup. The way he plays, you see, it frightens everybody because it's around a dangerous place. Yes, it's always at the enemy's gate. So it was very nice to watch because you feel happy all the time. Yes. But when the ball comes to our side, then you start going. It's terrible. And the tension mounts.
Yeah.
One day I was watching the World Cup. I think I was either watching on DSTV and my neighbor was watching on Ghana television, or he was watching on DSTV and I was watching on Ghana TV. So his home was ahead of mine. So I hear goal over to the house that I'm watching. No goal has happened. The tension was even more. So what is happening? Yeah. It was about 30 seconds delay. But it was terrible. But I knew that when I hear the shouting of goal, it must be us.
Yeah.
When it was silent, then it means that it will be. Because when we are scored, there's no sound. Satan has been attacking you, flooring you, destroying your family, destroying your house, destroying your everything, and you're always solving one thing or another. You understand? And now God is showing you the master key.
Come on.
We are moving the battle. So, okay, no problem. As for fight, we will fight. But where we will fight, we will fight it at your end.
At your end.
Right. How many would like a fight to be at the enemy's end?
Yes.
Yes. So, building of churches is always at the enemy's end. And all over the world, as I've traveled, I've noticed very few churches are being actually built. Yeah. This is one of the amazing things. You rarely see a church under construction. All over the world. I remember one time I was in the Caribbean driving through a certain island. It wasn't so big. As I went, all the churches were like from another era, but like a current project that a new pastor has come and building something new. No, which I didn't see it. And in America, many churches are for sale. In England, churches for sale. Everywhere, churches for sale. So when we rise up and we say, a thousand micro churches. As for problems in this life, we have them, no problem.
Yeah.
But we are moving the location.
Come on.
Are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we are moving the pressure to the enemy.
Yes.
And we are taking the initiative.
Yeah. We are taking the initiative.
You know what the initiative is? The initiative in war is when you start the war.
That's right.
And you are in control of it. Do you remember Black Hawk Down? Black Hawk Down is a film and it's also a true something that happened when America went to Somalia, I don't know, somewhere there. And they went into Somalia and they went out there and then something happened. But in the middle of the film, the commander, general, they attacked them and the commander said to his assistant, "We just lost the initiative." That means that although we started out in control, we just lost the control of this battle. And it's like we are now defending things. When you build churches, you have the initiative. Because you are doing something harmful to Satan and to his company.
Wow.
And you have the initiative. And the one who has the initiative is usually the one who wins.
Amen.
Yes.
So,
God is leading you to have the initiative.
Amen.
And to move the battle from your house. Instead of always praying about your financial issues, about your family issues, about your divorce issues, about your marriage issues, you have moved the thing to taking territory of the enemy in front of Satan's nose. Yes. And I see you doing that.
Amen.
Amen. Number four, you must build 1,000 micro churches because it is your way of following Jesus Christ.
Okay.
Amen. Why do I say that? Because 1 John chapter 3, verse 8 says, For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. You see, Jesus came to the world to destroy the works of the devil. That's why he came. So if you say you are a Christian, you must be out to destroy the works of the devil. That's
Amen.
Right. Your whole life must be destroying the works of the devil.
Amen.
And it is only through churches that you destroy the works of the devil.
That's right.
How many realize that Satan was spoiling your life? Like, look at how young you are. And you are already getting spoiled. Can you imagine how you will be spoiled by the age of 40? Completely spoiled. How many realize that many bad vices and traits were developing in you? Raise your hand. At the back there. Oh, upstairs people. Are you part of us? Yeah. Many bad characters. Some of you are learning how to be playboys. Playboys. Some of you are learning how to be traitors. Some of you are learning how to swerve people, how to dribble, to lie, to cheat, to steal. So many bad traits. You are learning it in school till Christ found you. So it is the presence of the church that causes the works of the devil that are manifested in the lives of people to be destroyed. Satan existed before we came. And somehow God also chose this earth to put man here. You know, when you go to Mars and they hear the sounds of wind and they see the dust and it's just empty, barren. That's how this earth was. The earth was without form and void. And God said, let there be light. And he brought about a creation and separated land from water, water on earth, on the land, from the waters in the sky. That's the waters in the sky that were passing by. They've just gone by. So there's not going to be rain now. There's some water over there. But it's gone the other way. And God said, let them feel, bring forth trees and green grass. Let them be animals. Let the city be filled with creatures. And he took the son and he made a man to look like him in his image. And he said, I call this for man. Then he made a woman out of the man. Wow. And he said, he blessed them. And he said, be fruitful, multiply. Things were amazing. Our brains were working at a high level. We could speak to animals that understand us. Snake, come to the left. Today, when you speak to your dog, Snake, it will be looking at you. Whoa, 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 whoa. When you see a cat, you say, stop it. Try our very nature. That is why human beings are so filled with evil. You can't even explain the wickedness and the hatred that are in just human beings. Even when we are Christians, you know, many things are done by Christians. You can't even believe the level of wickedness and hatred. There's no place, no country without wars in its history. You know, one day I saw a channel, history channel. You know, I didn't do history in school, so when I see such things, you know, I want to catch up with my wife, because she did history. History, I realized that it was all wars. So I didn't understand. But one day I realized that the history of man is wars. The past history of human beings is just fighting. If you leave us, we'll start fighting. It's a horrible nature. There's nobody's family here who doesn't fight amongst yourselves. If you are here and you have a family that fights amongst yourself, raise your right hand. Everybody has raised their hand. Now, Satan has destroyed our good nature. God made us in his image. And it is only opportunities for God's power to come into our lives. And that is why you are going to be involved in building 1,000 micro churches. And I'll show you. When God told Adam, replenish the earth. Adam looked at God and said, are you serious? Me. He said, you're filled the earth with people, your children. He looked at Eve and said, ah, do you know what it means? Amen. It is time to follow Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible says he came into this world to destroy the works of the devil. And the way the works of the devil are destroyed in these mountains is not just by prayer, but it's by building 1,000 churches all over the mountains and all over the city, everywhere the church of God preaches the word of God. Even with the church, you see the church is filled with thieves, liars, wicked people, deceivers, fornicators, all kinds of characters are in the church, even in the church. So 1,000 micro churches is God's way of defeating Satan. Jesus came into this world to destroy the works of the devil. And that's why when Jesus was going, he said, I will build my church.
Hallelujah.
I'll build my church.
Amen.
That's the only project Jesus is doing, is building his church. If you have another project, tell me. Number 5, you must build 1,000 micro churches because it is the reason for prosperity in the church. It's the reason for prosperity. 1 Chronicles 22 and verse 10. I gave it to you earlier. And 11. It says, he shall build a house for my name. He shall be my son. Are you watching? I will be his father. I will establish the throne of his kingdom over Israel forever. Now, my son, the Lord be with thee.
Amen.
Prosper thou.
Hallelujah.
And build the house of the Lord thy God.
Amen.
As he has said of thee. Prosper and build the house of God. I can tell every one of my church members, prosper.
Amen.
And build the house of God.
Amen.
Prosper and build the house. I'm giving you a reason for it. Because you see, at the point we have got something to eat, somewhere to stay, some for this, some, everything is finished. Prosper now.
Amen.
And build the house.
Amen.
What is the use of anything else? Prosper. Do you know, have you heard this word before? Investment banking.
Yeah.
Have you heard it before?
Yeah.
You know, I think if I'm right, the bankers will correct me. But I think it's not a normal bank. Is that so? Yeah, it's a bank for people who have a lot of money and they don't know what exactly to do with the money. They go for investment banking. Am I right? It's different from retail banking or consumer banking. Yes. Now that word investment bank, there are banks that unless you have some amount of money, you can't even open an account there. You see them there. And you ask yourself, what do they do? There are many people who have passed the stage of paying school fees, building houses, doing it. There's nothing else to do. So then they go to the investment bank. That's why you have all these bonds and all these things. Because what else should I do? But money doesn't make sense at a point. And that's why people become depressed. What should I do with all what I have? You may not understand it, but if the Lord blesses you to a point, you will start to see. And very soon you'll be seeing that. Hey, that investment banking, you were mentioning something investment banking. I'm not, you are you not an investment banker? Ah, is it an investment banker? Eh? Investment banker. I know you.
Keep preaching.
But now God is showing you. Today, you know, when I was coming, I was talking to somebody on a video call to one of our churches in central part of Africa. You know, the central part of Africa. I was discussing something about it, and he was telling me about some things that I needed in the church. because he just went there. You know, that I saw behind in the church. You know, there are no tiles in the church. It's like it's a church that is roofed, but it's like there's no, and it's so far from being completed. You know, we have so many churches which are in need of a builder. You get it?
Yeah.
Like money to continue building or finish building. Yeah. There is something to do with our prosperity.
Yeah.
And God is going to use you.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
In Nigeria, we are spreading heavy investments in Nigeria, in Ibadan, in Abeokuta, Calabar, Enugu. I'm talking about heavy investments to build a church. And Benin City. Yes, where the Dahusa was. And this morning I was having some discussions on a town called Yola in Adamawa State.
Yes.
And Lokoja. Lokoja. That is where the Benue River and the Niger River meet. And that's where they have their dam. Actually, I didn't know, I found out this morning, KD Dam. You see, we are trying to invest more and build the church in everything. If you are a pastor, not less than I'm saying if you are a pastor, if you are interested in souls, and in Nigeria, out of souls in Africa, 1, 2, 3, 4 is in Nigeria. 1, 2, 3, 4 Nigeria. 1, 2, 3, 4 Nigeria. How can it be that you are not interested in Nigeria? Or you understand my English question?
Yeah.
Is it an English question or not an English question?
It's an English question.
Yes. Yes. Unless it's something else we are after. Yeah. So let us have this mind that we are following Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. And that it is the reason for prosperity. Number six. A thousand micro churches is the way to seek the Lord first.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll show you. You see, many people say, oh, I'm seeking the Lord. I seek you first the kingdom of heaven. But what does it actually mean to seek the Lord? Look at 1 Chronicles chapter 22 and let's read from verse 18. The way to seek the Lord is what I want to show you. 1 Chronicles chapter 22 and verse 18. Now Solomon was being spoken to by his father David, and he said, and we are going to read verse 18 and 19. He said, is not the Lord with you? And has he not given you rest on every side? No, has God not blessed you? For he has given thee the inhabitants of the land into thine hand, and their hand is subdued before the Lord and before his people. Verse 19, beautiful. Now, are you ready to underline?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Now, set your heart and your soul to seek the Lord your God. Do you see? How? That's it, says semicolon. Arise therefore and build. Arise you therefore and build the sanctuary.
Amen.
Of the Lord God.
Hallelujah.
To bring the ark of the covenant of the Lord and the holy vessels into the house that the Lord, that is to be built by the name of the Lord. Set your heart and your soul to seek the Lord. Set your heart to seek God. Brothers and sisters, all over the world, I'm telling you, set your heart to seek the Lord. Put your mind on seeking the Lord. He said, then arise. Underline it. Arise therefore, because you are seeking the Lord. Arise therefore and build ye the sanctuary of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
1,000 people who are seeking the Lord with 1,000 efforts to build 1,000 micro churches. And a basenta is like a micro church.
Yeah.
A placenta is a micro church.
Yeah.
A basenta and a ubasenta, every type of center is a micro church.
That's right.
Yes.
We are building.
Amen.
Amen.
I recently met with my crusade directors and I told them, I'm not going to allow you to be a crusade director without being involved in the church. No, I don't want any such person in my life. I sent into church work. Say, yes, we are doing crusades, but everybody is into church.
Yeah.
1,000 micro to everybody must be, all of us, even my Greater Love Club, the kind of outreach that they've done this month.
Wow.
The children are trembling. They realize that there's a seniority in things. There's a seniority in things. Yes. A type of soul that they've won this month alone is serious. Yes. The children are trembling. Yes. Let's look at that beautiful verse again. I'm showing you how many want to know how to seek the Lord. He said, seek the kingdom of God. Look at this verse. It says, now set your heart and soul to seek the Lord. How will you seek the Lord? Arise therefore and build ye the sanctuary of the Lord your God. That's all. Just get up and start building, 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 soul winning, shepherding, visiting, calling people, telling pastoring, getting informed, follow up, shepherding, shepherding, moving out, soul winning, crusade, breakfast meeting, physical buildings, everything, 1,000 micro churches.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number 7. Are you there?
We are here.
You must build 1,000 micro churches because it is your way to build a magnificent church.
Wow.
A magnificent church. Hey. How do you build a magnificent church? A magnificent church is like a beautiful church.
Yeah.
A really wonderful church. Huh? I really want a wonderful church. You know, I'm so happy. If I go to London, I'll have a church.
Mm.
If I go to Germany, I can go to church. If I go to KJV, I have a church.
Yeah.
If I go to Tamale, I have options.
Yeah.
On Sunday. You know, now I've decided that when I go for crusade, I'll preach in my town. I'll find about 3 churches. I'll go and preach in all the small churches. Yeah, everywhere. 1,000 micro churches. First Chronicles. I want to show you a magnificent church.
Preach.
Now, verse 3. First Chronicles 22, verse 3. And David prepared in abundance the nails for the doors. Verse 4. Also cedar trees in abundance. Now, verse 5. And David said, Solomon, my son, is young and tender, and the house that is to be builded, the church, you know,
okay,
that we are going to build for the Lord, must be what? Exceeding magnificent. Exceeding magnificent.
Wow.
Hey, of fame and of glory throughout all countries. All countries must enjoy this exceeding magnificent church of fame and glory throughout all countries. 190 nations and more. I will therefore now make preparation for it. So David prepared abundantly before his death. Yes, this is the way to build a very magnificent church. Yes, it must be exceeding magnificent, of fame and of glory throughout all countries. I can see my pastor here from Barcelona. You see some of you, stand up, Barcelona bishop here. You see some of you, you only know Barcelona as a football team, but as a pastor from Barcelona. And Barcelona, a bishop. Yeah. Practical. And I see another pastor from Panama City.
Wow.
And in South America. Look at him.
Barcelona.
You see, the church that is to be built must be what? Exceeding magnificent of fame and glory throughout all countries. Wow. Ah, God for Jesus. Mauritius, isn't it?
Oh.
Yes. As a lay pastor without salary and any of those other payments and whatever, he's very excited. He's a volunteer. He's excited. And Benin, how is he? Cotonou, look at him from Cotonou, Benin. Beautiful. He's so excited to be here. I sent him to different countries. Which other country have you? Central Africa. Bangui. Yeah, Bangui. And where again? Cameroon. And then Benin. Are you happy to be there? Super happy. He's a bishop. My bishops are young men. They are yet to grow old. Yes. The church that is to be built is what? Exceeding magnificent of fame and glory throughout all countries. Clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus. And you see, without 1,000 micro churches, do you get it? How will it have this characteristic? It can't have this characteristic. Exceeding magnificent. Now, I don't even understand the purpose, so that's why I said that magnificent.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But the Bible word is exceeding magnificent of fame and glory throughout all countries. Beautiful. Tell your neighbor, tell me I'm part of the magnificent, exceeding magnificent something, something, something.
Tell
your neighbor I'm part of the exceeding something, something, something magnificent. Yes, yes. Now, you know, our pastors in Bangladesh, in Dhaka, the city is called Dhaka. You know, they were there before, and they came to Ghana, and then they've gone back. And they were telling them about our Bangladeshi members. You know, since they left, the members are in touch with them. Oh, yeah. It's like their church is exceeding magnificent. Yes. Not India, Bangladesh. You only know India, but I'm talking of Bangladesh. Beautiful. The other day I put on Netflix. Yeah, Netflix. You listen to the story before you start shouting. Do you want to hear my story? I put on Netflix and I put it on and I saw a lot of films. Then I suddenly saw an Indian film. Like the people in the film were all Indians and they were all speaking Indian language, not English. So I don't know why I decided to press play, play. Let's see what is in India. When the film started, they entered into a coffee shop. Yeah, and some people were eating there. That was how the film started. And then I saw the address of the place. He said, the place was a shop in a city called Pune. So I said, ah, Pune, that is where our church is. We have a church at this place in the next place. The next place is showing our church. The next place is showing our church. Clap for Jesus. It is a city magnificent church of fame and glory. Netflix. Pune, the town is called, the city is called Pune. And Bishop Isaac was what? Yeah, he served in that church in Pune. Yeah. Now, there was also India has 1. Something billion people. So when I look, I say, ah, that is our church, it's a Pune. Pastor Peter, he's the one who went to start the church there. It's an address. Yeah. Faustina was also in Pune. Were you in Pune? Yeah, you see, our church is even on Netflix. Clap for Jesus. Amazing. Amen. Now turn to Titus chapter 2.
Keep reaching. Keep reaching. Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, I see the magnificence of this, of this, of the amenities. This is the last reason for 1,000 micro churches.
Wow.
The next reason I will give you at Flow Prayer Meeting. But this is the last one. It says, verse 11, the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared. Charlie, are you glad you are saved? How many realize that you are more like an animal before you were saved? How many were animalistic, 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 animalistic? Hey! Now, what is the grace of God doing? Teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly. Soberly. Righteously and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope and glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ. How many are looking forward to the great glory?
I'm looking forward. I'm looking forward.
You know, some of you are going to be wearing crowns.
Oh.
I tell you, you and Queen Elizabeth will be moving together in the glory. Well, I hear the queen is a believer.
Wow.
So even though your queenship hasn't come on air and your kingship hasn't manifested, you get it, you'll be shocked at the crown you'll be wearing.
Wow.
You'll be walking around like this. Beautiful.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Beautiful. Beautiful.
You'll be royalty. How many know that we are going to have a royal family in heaven? Would you like to be part of the royal family?
Yeah.
Hmm. Beautiful. Now, verse 14. Who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. Amen. Amen. Is your way, hallelujah, of being zealous of good works. Yes. A peculiar, unusual people. Zealous of good works. Zealous of good works. Amen.
Amen.
Zealous means one bearing with zeal. Amen.
Amen.
Another meaning is most eagerly desirous. Most eagerly desirous. You see, when you are part of 1,000 micro churches, it shows you are most eagerly desirous of God's work and of God. you know, before church. And he told me that, look, I was in various, I was in a church and so on. He said, but he taught me, he said, I know about God, but he taught me to love God. And he gave a long speech. He said that to know God and to love God, he said, I learned it from you. That God is somebody who can be loved. He said, that's what I've learned from you. And I came to honor you because I've learned that God can be known. You can love God. You can serve God. He said, I learned it from you. A medical doctor. He said, I've come to honor you. Yeah, I learned that from you, that God can be loved. You can love God. I was touched by his speech. Yeah, I've learned from you that God can be loved. You can love God. That's what I learned from you. To be most eagerly desirous of God. Then, are you listening? How many want to be zealous? Yes, zealous. Ha, matter almost chapter. The next one is to defend and uphold a thing vehemently. You see, you are defending the church vehemently. Yes. To defend the thing. You see, a zealous person is strong to defend the church. To be very strongly desirous of God. Strongly defending something. It shows your zeal. That's why when Jesus got up and whipped the people in the temple, he said, "Get up from here, imposters, liars, thieves, move from the house of God." He lashed them out. I'm surprised that they don't allow lashing in school. If Jesus himself was lashing, he lashed them and drove them out of the church. And then the Bible says they remembered the saying that the zeal of my Father has consumed me. The zeal of God. To be strongly defensive of what you are and what you have of God's house. To fight for something with all your strength. And a thousand micro churches with fighting for a church everywhere. Look. Many towns I've been to, I thank God today that, you know, we built churches. One of the furthest towns I ever went to is a town called Zwedru. Not Zwedru, Zwedru in Liberia. Yeah. When I met Mrs. Taylor, Charles Taylor's wife, she said, "When I heard you are going to Zwedru," I said, "Why? What are you going to do there? All these places." That's the hometown of Sergeant Doe. Most vehemently defending the church, that the church must also be here. Today we are building a cathedral and offices. We are now constructing the offices in that Zwedru. Yes. Sakumon, what is it called? What is the church? Kadia Mountain Center. Yeah, they have those missionaries there. All those guys. And they are young men. They work as teachers in Liberia. They work as teachers. They are not made payments. Wow. As most of our pastors are. Most of our pastors. Vehemently defending the church in Zwedru. That there must be one here too. Why should he be scrapped off the man? Why? What is wrong with the people here? Why should they be exempted from the power and the grace of God?
Why? Good question.
The seal of my Father's house has possessed me. Listen, from today I charge you, prosper and build the house. The two of them, they go together. Yeah. Prosper and do percentages. Yeah. Prosper and do outreaches. Yeah. Prosper and build physical buildings. And finance the church. Prosper and be part of 1,000 micro churches. Listen, write it down. There's nothing like too many churches. There's nothing like that. There's nothing like too many churches. I went to Singapore. Somebody told me, but I saw it with my eyes. A shop. Where they've written the name of the shop is not something boutique or whatever. The shop is called There Is Nothing Like Too Many Shoes Limited. To attract ladies. Yes. It's a long sentence. There is nothing like Too Many Shoes Limited. Come and see shoes with ladies. Everybody's trying on. You have a brown one, but you want a slightly browner brown. That's it. They were there, full up. It's not too much. I have some news to you for you. There is nothing like too many churches. Yes. This is a great blessing. So now your zeal is going to be shown. He said, the Bible said that God gave himself that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify to himself a strange peculiar people. Are you glad to be peculiar?
Yes.
And what is this peculiar? Zealous of good works.
Zealous of good works.
From today, you show your zeal by joining 1,000 micro churches.
Amen.
Yes. You show your zeal. And you see, you immediately change the pattern from your psychological and mental problems to a problem in front of the gates of heaven. You watch and see.
Yeah.
Everything will change for your life.
Everything.
You know, how can I, my personal issues, do you see? My mind is on the church.
Yeah.
And the issues with the church.
Yeah.
Yeah. All the time. Yeah. Today, I'm having meetings about our churches in Kenya. You know, so many of the branches. Nakuru, which is outside Nairobi, Machakos, Kabete, Tika, Central Business District, Mombasa. I mean, we have discussions and meetings. There are so many things to do. So many. Everything we are trying to do with Uganda, and in Uganda, the Entebbe Church, and the Bulu Church, and the ones in Kampala, and the ones, the Tesla, and Mbarara, and all these. And trying to organize them. Oh, please.
Please.
Zealous of good works.
Amen.
You stop counting money to buy corned beef.
Amen.
I said, you stop counting money to buy corned beef. You stop counting money to buy petrol.
Yeah.
You stop counting money to buy school fees.
Yeah.
Ah, the world will move to another place, right? School fees war is not on at all.
Yeah.
You know a lot of people quarrel about school fees.
Yeah.
School fees can bring a whole crisis to a family. Yeah. But soon, you will not even have any one discussion about it. The discussion will be something, check this, because you've moved the thing. To the enemy's gate, everything is in front of his house. Exceeding magnificent.
Oh,
are you excited about the thousand?
Very.
So now, wherever you are, from that place is becoming 1,000. So my pastor, my bishop from Benin, I'm charging you with 1,000 micro churches in the country of Benin. Benin, 1,000 micro churches.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
You know something?
Yeah.
If you are in a country, anything less than 1,000 churches in your country is not acceptable.
Yes, it's not acceptable.
Ask your neighbor, you are from where? Are you a visitor or you are
here? Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, we need 1,000, please. We need 1,000.
Accra!
First love, we need 1,000 in Accra.
Yeah.
1,000 churches in Accra.
Yeah.
We are 760.
Wow.
Yeah.
We must rise and be there in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall be there.
Ask your neighbor, are you a visitor? I see a pastor from Abuja here.
Are you a visitor?
Abuja, wait. Abuja. We need 1,000, right? Nigeria is big, okay? Can't be standing here with one church. Any one church person challenge, we 1,000 of them. How many want the 1,000 from Pedrasi Lodge? To where? Yes, a two pro. 1,000. Can it be possible? Never come and mention your church without me. One church, or we have two branches. Ah!
Yeah.
We passed that stage. Long time. How many are going to be involved? You see, when you have 20 people, you are doing well. When you have 10 people, you are also doing well. Yeah.
Yeah.
You see your whole problem. Say, I'm looking for a husband. You see, the husbands will be looking for you. Yeah. Thing has changed. The whole thing has changed. The whole thing has changed. You will be struggling to choose which of the options to choose.
It shall happen in Jesus' name.
Say 1,000 micro churches. 1,000 micro churches. Wow. Next week, I'm going to show you how you can turn into a church. You do turn into a church. You know Jacob?
Yes.
I like Jacob. There's something I read about Jacob that made me like him. I realized that he was a great father. He said, look, I passed over this Jordan, and when we go to Israel, you see the Jordan. I passed over this river with my walking stick. I was just holding a stick, a staff. But now that I'm coming back after 14 years, I've become two huge companies of goats, sheep, wives, children. I mean, I have four wives, like two real wives and four semi-demi wives. You get it? And children, baby, and their servants, and cows and goats, animals, and me. And you see, what aren't you happy to meet a grateful person who can actually recognize that 14 years ago, I was passing from this place, I had nothing in my hand. And now I've come back with so many people that are competing me. What a blessing. And I realized that that is why God chose Jacob. There are some people who don't remember anything. It's as if they are having amnesia. Yeah. But Jacob, he said, hey God, you have done a lot for me. Tell your neighbor, God has done a lot for us. Now I hope you remember today that I'm launching 1,000 micro churches. That maybe as you are standing only with your Bible. But you are soon going to be standing with some companies. Yes. Yes. Fantastic. Tell your neighbor, I'm impressed with your pastoral fruits. I'm impressed with your pastoral fruits. And I can see our pastor from Niamey, Niger. She's right here. From Niger. She's a medical doctor. She works as a doctor and she does the job. Are we sending any payment to you or whatever? She's happy to be there. Amazing. Every standing. 1,000 micro churches. 1,000 micro churches. Tell your neighbor, I know you are a businessman, but this one there, you are involved in the 1,000 micro churches. I know you are a businessman. But you are involved 100%. Now, I want to see that verse before we close. Exceeding magnificent something, 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 something. Do you like that exceeding magnificent something, something? Are you happy that next time you are in Frankfurt, there will be a church? There is a church there in Frankfurt. Hamburg is there. Ah, this was Hamburg. He started a church in Hamburg. Fantastic.
Oh, Jesus.
Aha, have you found the best? Look at it. Underline, the man is not underlining. Solomon, my son, is young. Are you young?
Yes.
Are you young?
Yes.
And you're old now.
No.
When you have all these type of messages, you can't receive them. But even my greater life, since they came here, most of them have lost about 20 years of their age.
Yeah.
20 years, most of them.
Yeah.
They have become very young and flexible.
Very young and flexible.
So I'm now looking for beloveds for them, I tell you. If the children are not serious, you see the weddings will start at the greater land and you'll be shocked.
Wow.
The church must be what? Exceeding magnificent of fame and of glory throughout all countries. Give the Lord a shout and a clap. Amen. Lift your hand and just thank God for one time. Everywhere you are based is turning into 1,000 micro churches. Everywhere you are based is turning into 1,000 micro churches. Father, we give you thanks. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We lift our hands and we thank you for the vision to build 1,000 micro churches. To you be the glory, to you be the honor, to you Lord be the praise. Thanks a million, thanks a million, thanks a million for the things that you have done. Thanks a million. We pray, Jesus, we give you thanks.
Oh, lift up your hand and begin to talk to God. Begin to talk to God, everybody. Open your mouth and pray right now. Commit yourself to God right now. Everybody pray. Pray that God will use you. Pray that God will use you in these times. In the name of Jesus, commit yourself to Him. Pray that you'll be part of the people that God will use in these end times. Makota Mashakatamane. Libro Sikatamane. Open your mouth and pray. Wherever you are, God is looking for people to use in these times. Oh yes, we are young and tender. We can be used by God. We are flexible in the house of God. Oh yes, Lord. If you can use the living Lord, use me. If you can use the living Lord, use me. Take my hands and my feet, Lord. Touch my heart and speak through me. Oh God, if you can use anything, oh God, use me tonight. Mako Santa Mamoru Moshikata Mamaba. Rabama Boya Surama Mamaba. Likatoya Masuta Mamadiri Mandana Mashika Mamada. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Oh, thank you, Lord. Take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Lift up your hand and sing a song to the Lord. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. The words are on the screen. Take my hands and my feet, Lord. Take my hands, Lord, and my feet. Oh, touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. Oh, if you can use.
Power. Two nations are in my womb. The Lord said to Rebecca, two nations are in the womb. As I anoint you with oil, I declare that the nations that are in your womb, may they come forth. May they come forth. There are churches in your womb. In the name of Jesus.
Let it be a fresh anointing for
fresh move of your Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, O God, for a fresh wind that is coming, O God. In these times, thank you that our blessings will receive many churches. Many churches. Many, that's the anointing branches all over. Every part will be having branches. Thank you for many churches. Many Michael churches. We bless you all. We thank you, O God. In the name of Jesus.
Find yourself doing in the house of God. It's time to move to the next level.
receive it. Yes, yes, yes. A new place, a new place is coming upon you. Jesus. Yes, you have a peculiar calling upon your life. It is not a normal calling, but it's a special calling. See, the Lord is a call to the health ministry, but it's also a great calling. And God is using you in that area to establish great things in His house. As you give yourself to it, may you be used by the Lord mightily. In the name of Jesus. As you see the kingdom, prosper and build, prosper and build, prosper and build. In the name of Jesus, yes. Makola basita la bande, ina kosa la bando ya shaka tala mama mama.
Same Lord. We are different.
verses in that inflation. That is the same God that working all in all, and is working in you. He's working in you.
Or your first and best, I want to pray with you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, yes. You are here amongst us, for we have gathered in your name. We can feel your presence in this place. Oh, you are here. You are here amongst us. You are enthroned upon our praise. You are here. Here to hear and here to say. This week, in the name of Jesus, you want to give 30, 40, 30, or 20. I want you also to rise up and come. You are giving by mobile. The number is 055-771-4458. 055-771-4458. Rise up and come. You want to give 40, 30, 20. Clap for them as they come. 40, 30, 20. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. You want to give 10 cities, also rise up and come. 10 Ghana cities, clap for them as they come. 10 Ghana cities. Do this. When the anointing is strong, make sure that you just tap into it, because there's a blessing that you will never have at some other time in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you. Thank you for grace, for prosperity. You said you will prosper us so that we can build the church. May we receive it in Jesus' name. Five cities rise up and come. Five Ghana cities, clap for them as they come. Five Ghana cities, come all the way to the front. Five Ghana cities, in the name of Jesus. Four Ghana cities, three cities, two cities, one city, rise up and come. Please clap for them, clap for them. Everyone that is giving, come all the way to the front. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. May he remember you. May he make a way for you when there seems to be no way. In the name of Jesus. Now, everybody take out a booster. A booster, a booster. In the name of Stevie, come let me pray with you. A booster, everybody take out something extra. In the name of Jesus. Father, thank you, oh God. May you be that anointed minstrel of the Lord. May an anointing be on you to play like David played. That evil spirits went out of people. May you have that anointing to do even greater, to play and bring the presence of God tonight. I felt a strong presence on you to play as you were playing, as you were playing, as you were playing. Ah, Riko Shita Bambaba, Riko Tonya Santa Bayane. Oh, yes, a new anointing, a fresh anointing has come upon you to play in the house of God, to play. As you play, lives are affected in the name of Jesus. As you play, the presence of God will fill the house anytime you play. Receive it, receive it, receive it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Holy Ghost, we bless you. Hallelujah. Lift up your booster, Father. As your people bring their boosters, Father, give them boosters. Prosper them, bless them, increase them, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ, have your way in your lives. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come all the way to the front. Yes, receive miracle jobs, miracle blessings, miracle babies, miracle weddings, miracle houses, miracle cars. In the name of Jesus, something miraculous is taking place. Something miraculous is taking place. Somebody this Sunday, you are supposed to come and give a testimony. So something is going to happen between now and Sunday, and you are coming to share that testimony. That is what the Spirit of the Lord is telling me. Please, when it happens, don't keep that testimony. Come and share it on Sunday. You are here. You are that person. And God is going to give you a special blessing. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow, what a blessing. Father, we thank you for all those of you joining us on Facebook. God bless you so much. We love you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. God bless.